What's good, y'all? It's old school. That young dude, more wisdom than an old fool. CEO, Two Square ENT LLC, back with another beat. I got a request from my homeboy off TikTok, Double R, aka Rashard. Wanted me to do Little Corey's If I Was Older. So I'm finna do that right now. And so, yeah. So back to the main screen. I already sampled a track because I sampled it off my phone. I can't show y'all exactly how I did it again, but how I went about doing it is I'll go over here to shift, edit sample, and then it'll bring me to this screen right here. And then I'll play it off my phone and it'll go in here and I'll hit record. And then once I'm done with that, it'll ask me if I want to save it and all that good stuff. So I already did that. So I'm gonna bring the sample back up by going to edit samples. And I just gotta scroll and with this and find it. Or I could just tap it in here and then go down and find it right there. If I Was Older, Little Corey. So I got the BPM set to like 70 something. It's like a R&B track, so it's slow. So now what I'm about to do is I'm about to go over here to trim till it says chop, and so I can manually chop it, and that's what I'm gonna attempt to do. But I also can hit threshold and it'll chop it by the threshold, which is basically where the lines start and stop, regions, and it just automatically chop it for me. If I chopped it by threshold, it'll chop it up a lot more. So I kind of like that better. And if you notice, I got a lot more than I've been playing. So you got banks on here. So if I go to pad bank B, and then so on. So, but what I'm about to do is I'm about to erase all that by holding down shift over here and then hitting clear all. So I'm about to clear all these lines, these chops. No more chops. Now, what I'm about to attempt to do, which is going to be kind of hard because there's no drums at the beginning, I'm going to try to chop as it plays. And then I might have to fine tune and go and, you know, get it a little bit more detailed. But yeah, so I got it on manual right now, and I got this, if you can see right here, this little play, wherever this play is at is where it's gonna start. Of course I wanted to start at the beginning, so let's just do it. Let's see if I can get it. Hold up, wait, this will kind of help me first. I got my tempo set to 64, so let's just play it. One, two, three, four. So I need to be like, okay, I think I got it. So let's go back to edit samples, trim to chop, manual. Let's go. B. So if you notice, it sped up in the middle of me chopping whenever the kick and the drums came in. So that means my BPM is actually faster than what I thought. So how I'm gonna fix this is I'm gonna get rid of that. Oh wait, wrong way. What am I doing? Okay, so there we go. We got rid of that anyway. So what I'm gonna do, I don't know, it didn't. Shift, clear out. I'm gonna actually play the sample. I'm gonna play the sample. We're gonna start where the drums kick it, come in. And then I'm gonna tap tempo. What this will do, it will get my tempo closer to what, because what I did, I went to Google and looked up the tempo of the track, and a lot of time Google would be wrong. So this is how we're going to fix that. We're going to play it. And I'm gonna just tap to it. Voila. I'm messing it up. I'm gonna have to erase those later. When the drums come in, we're gonna hit tap tempo. See if I can keep up. That should be enough. So we're at 63.97. We're not that far from where we was at. So let's go back to here, trim, chop. Now we should be able to do it on beat. So yeah, let's try to do it again. Let's see if we can do it. Oh, them chops are still there. We gotta erase those. Clear up. Okay, now we should be good. Still messed up. It's faster. It's all good though. We can go back and edit those later. For this video, I probably won't use the vocal chops, but I don't know, we'll see. I want to make this video quick, so we went back to pad A, so now I'm about to just see how the pad sounds, and then we chopped it up. If you chop right, you should just be able to play through the tempo. I don't know what happened to that chop right there. I noticed, I think I hit something wrong when I was doing it, so there's nothing right there when it should be, but whatever. If you do it right to the tempo, it shouldn't be glitchy at all. I'm gonna show you what I mean. You hear that hiccup? That's because I was off beat right there when I was chopping. But it's all good because all I got to do is go in here. See how I stretch that little part out? So right there is where it got cut off at. All I got to do is scoot this over. Sound better, right? And then this part right here, like I said, I messed up. And I could fix that. Oh yeah, okay, it's working. One thing I ain't figured out yet, you see how I just split this apart? It's pad 6, and right behind it is pad B. Sometimes the ends will stick. See, like, it's doing that now. So I probably just messed this up. The end of 6 will stick to 7, so wherever I move 6, 7 will go. But it don't have to do that. You don't have to do that. I just can't remember how to take that off. But anyway. I'm pretty satisfied with my chops. So we need to consolidate these and put them on the pads. They're on the pads, but they're just not saved to the pads. So when we go back to the main screen, it won't be there. So what we need to do now is we need to hit shift, See, these buttons have multiple things they can do. And so when you hit shift, that's the second part of the button. So you see it's changing when I hit shift. So we're gonna hit shift and we're gonna hit convert. I'm gonna try to do this with my knuckle. Okay, so now it gives us options. New drum program using slices. That's what we want. Or we can do new clip program. New program with samples. Assign slice to one pad. That's just one, the pad that we had highlighted. Make new sample. We can turn this whole chop into just one whole sample, consolidate it. Patch phrases, I'm not sure what that is, but I'm gonna just go back to new program using slices. Hit do it. Now we go back to the main screen, and this is the programs. There's nothing on this program. This program one is empty. If I was older, little Corey program, this is the one we just made. So here goes the samples. It's gonna be a challenge for me, so now I'm gonna have to put the phone down for a little bit, try to groove to this. But we on track one. This is where my sample chops is gonna be. Now, track two, this is where I'm gonna put my, I'm gonna start my drums at. And so these are right here where I just went real quick. I went to, we was just at edit sample. Now we're going to assign samples because I need my drums. And these right here is built-in drum packs from people at Akai, MPC. You can preview when you just scroll through the different sounds that's on the pad. But what I'm going to use is I'm going to go to some programs that I've made myself. So, and I saved them into the internal storage. So I went to internal, MPC documents, programs, and go up to this icon for the pads. And then, so I can't preview my stuff for some reason. It says audition, but it don't, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what I want. But, so this is like my trap kit I got from Producer Grind. This right here is what I just made from a SP-1200. If you into production, you into production, you probably know what SP-1200 is made. A lot of old school classics, a lot of the stuff we heard back in the 90s. So I got some sounds from that. Then I don't know if I want to use that though. And I got my Bare Essential sound pack. It was pretty much all the latest sounds you really mostly hear. I got my West Coast sound pack, my main drum sound pack that I always use. I'm trying to stop using so much. I really don't know what I want to use. My Somatics, lo-fi drum sounds, East Coast sound drum. So I might have to experiment with this, but I think I'm going to start. I'm probably just gonna start with my main, or no? Let me go with my Producer Grind kit. That way I can tag them in the video. Okay, so I'll go back to my main screen, and I'm gonna make sure track two is on my Zone 6 drum program, and as you can hear. That's what we got. So I only got three banks worth of sounds on here. So now, people always say you want to start with your drums first. A lot of people say that. Everybody's different. I think that's what I'm gonna do, because as far as the samples, if I go back to track one, I really don't know what I'm gonna do with this. This might be a long video. Well, I'll chop it up and post it everywhere else, though. Another method that I usually do is, okay, like, you hear this pad's got some bass. You hear this pad? It's got like a snare. This has got a kick. So I would just chop from kick all the way to the snare and cut it off, and that'd be one pad. Then the snare all the way to the kick would be another pad. And then, you know, I'll try to find one where it's just a hi-hat. And then I would make a little loop like that and have my chops like that. This time I didn't do that. I just kind of was just going to the tempo of the beat. And usually when you go to the tempo of the beat, you will, you know, occasionally catch, like I said, a bass, a snare, and a kick. But it don't always happen like that if you're just going to the tempo. But enough talk, man. I'm going to flip this camera around. You're going to see me in my dirty car, my crazy haircut. And then, we're just going to cook and have a good time, man. I'm going to set y'all down. Kind of in an awkward position because I'm on a hill. I don't know why I parked here. Anyway, let's see. So yeah, I said we're gonna start with the drums. And another thing too, let me show you this real quick. See, it says 16 levels. Okay, you hear this 808? If I break it down into 16 levels, listen to it now. Spreads it out. I can also do that if I come here. I'm gonna have to flip the screen back around. I can also do that here. So no, I would do it in edit sample. So the last thing I hit was the 808 pad. If I go to edit samples, or no, my bad, it's warp samples. I can change the time, I can stretch it, and I also can hit this little magic button right here with these keys. And then it spreads it out on my keys. But I don't know if I'm gonna do that all that right now. I think I'm gonna make a simple, just a simple drum. Just for the sake of the video, I don't want to make this super long. So, I need to go back to my drum pads. Oh, I do gotta show y'all this too though. Because this is what I'm about to record first. So, I'm about to record the hi-hat first, just to give us a little groove and vibe or whatever. So, one thing I really like about this that I don't think you can do on FL Studios. So I'm gonna use this hi-hat right here. So what I'm about to do now is I'm about to hit note repeat twice. I'm gonna double tap it. Watch what happens on the screen. So now that I double tap that, you can hold it down, but if you double tap it, it just stays up. So you have your time increments. You see that? Watch when I hold down. Wait. If I go to another one, look. See that? Then I like this one too. It makes it off. It's easier to hear if I go down lower. Look. It's easy to do drum rolls and stuff like that. Right, let's go, let's get into it. So now what I'm about to do, I'm gonna hit record and play. If I hit this record button, it destroys anything else that I have on this track, which I don't have anything, but if I did, it would just erase everything as I go. Now, if I hit overdub, it's just gonna dub what I got. It's gonna keep what I got plus what I'm putting on there. If I hit play, it's going to play wherever I started off last. If I hit play start, it's going to start from the very beginning. So let's just get some simple hi-hat going down. I'm going to hit record, and I'm going to hit play. And see, if I wasn't holding my phone and doing this at the same time, I could hit one of these buttons down here and do a little quick roll. But I'm going to still do the roll. I'm just going to do it. See, now I'm overdubbing it. See that? Switch. Oh, yeah. I still got to hold the button down. I forgot. Okay, yeah. I'm going to have to sit y'all down. Okay, I'm just gonna do this all the way over. So there goes our hi-hat. Take it off record dub. Flip this thing. So now we're gonna go up here. We're gonna name our track. Got to keep everything organized. Just name it hat. Now we over here. Like I said, I'm just gonna keep this simple for the sake of the video. I ain't gonna try to get fancy. Just gonna add this snare here real quick. And because I have, I don't have it on. I'm gonna hit time correction, 1/16. So everything should be on time now. Well, my snare should be at least. So now we got that. I'm gonna double tap note repeat to take note repeat off. And we're gonna add our kick after we name this track snare, of course. I forgot, this sound pack don't really got no kick. It just got 808s. Some people just make tracks with 808s. That's cool. I like to do both. So I'm about to pull up another drum program. So I hit plus sign for drum program. Assign samples, browse. And I got a real punchy kick right here on the my main drum program. So I'm going to load that up. Go back to main screen. And I don't hear nothing. That's because we're on program 2. I got to go to my main program drums right there. And I'm going to show y'all a little hack. So I told y'all about the 16 levels right here. Right? Now when you hear like boom, boom, sometimes like it's cool to go to a lower kick and then go to a higher one. Like that right there. Let's do that. So record, play. Now I think we good. We're gonna go back to these samples. See what we can do. I still got my 16 levels on. You notice that? So I'm gonna turn it off. Play this mug backwards, let's see how it sounds. Hold on, I'm gonna get surgical with this hoe. Wait, hold up. Wait, hold up. I might have something. Let me see. To chop it up just a little bit better. Okay, so like this pad right here is in it too soon. So I'ma tap it like I just did. We go to edit sample and we gonna stretch that hole. Just like my baby mom been stretched. Anyway, TMI. Let's go back. We don't have to save or do nothing, it's already been edited. Let's see if that worked. Now we're just gonna hit play. See how it sounds now. One thing I wanna look at now is I usually like to not only chop my samples, but I like to pitch them, add some effect, make it sound different. You know what I'm saying? So one way we can do that is multiple ways to do it. That's what I like about this machine too. I mean, other dolls and stuff do it too, but anyway. So I'm gonna hit. So what I did, I went to my buttons down here, and I went and I hit edit. So this came up, and so now I'm gonna hit global, which means it's not just gonna affect one pad. It's gonna affect my whole program when we hit global. So if I got this right here, it's at poly, it's mono. I don't fully understand all of it, but I just know if I put this on poly, when I hit one pad, it's not going to stop another pad from playing. So I did that. And then if I go up here to semi, I'm going to pitch it down. I'm going to show you. I'm going to hit play and I'm going to pitch it down. I'm going to show you. So I can move my finger over here. Or I can use this. But I like using this though. That's just one semi note. I'm going to go down one more. I think I am gonna turn it back to mono though, so the pads will stop each other. It sound better. So I'm gonna name this samples And then see, this is just a 4-bar loop. See, right there. So what I could do now is I can add, I'm gonna just show you. Oops, I almost dropped my phone. My fingers on the camera. My bad. So now, there's multiple ways to do this too. But what, how, the way I'm about to do it, I want to show y'all. So I'm going to come up here. And I could either go over here and hit double link. And that will give us 8 bars. And it will just be the same thing. And then I can go to my grid view and then just take out what I don't want. But instead of doing that, I'm just going to tap on bars, insert 8. And so now the first 4 bars would be what you heard before. And then the next 4 bars after that will just be empty. It won't be nothing. So, but okay, what I'm going to do now, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go back to my 4 bars. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to hit edit. Because I don't want to have to stretch out my drums too. And I don't want to have to redo it. So I am going to double the length. And that's going to turn that 4 bars into 8. And everything's just going to play as is. But now I'm going to go over here to my grid view. And right up here where it say 4. I'm just going to delete the sample chops that it copied. So you'll still hear my drums, but you won't hear no more samples past 4 bars, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some more sample chops. So I'm hit shift and I'm gonna hit, let's see, cut. So now let's play and see what we got. I need to save this too. Make sure you always save. So just save this as DR or double R. It says he requested this. So, just in case my car or something mess up. Alright, so now let's play and see what we got. So now, let me see if I can undo, because I want to keep that last chop, and we'll get rid of the rest of these. So shift, cut, and then we're going to make up a new chop. We're going to make up a new chop to go with what we got now, so it won't get boring. You know, Sarah. We're just gonna rock with it. Y'all ready? I don't know, I'm just trying stuff. Cool, but I'm gonna look for another chop.
She'll be my girl and I'm be my girl and I'm be my girl and I'm be
be my girl. Okay, to be my girl, I'm gonna take the B part off, so I'm gonna go to edit sample.
Be my girl.
So just say my girl.
Girlin'.
Or maybe I'm gonna say my girl, and then we gon' if we don't like that.
My girlin'.
Okay.
My girlin'.
Alright, so what I said.
My girlin'.
I don't like that, and we're gonna check that. So I might put my back on
my
there.
Girlin'.
Oh, I got my on there already, so.
My girlin'.
And take the and part off.
My girl.
I don't know. We're gonna see, y'all. So, I don't want to start off from the very beginning. I'll just stop where this second part of the chops is at. And then, so how do we do that? Remember, we overdub. We don't want to erase nothing. And then we're going to hit play right here instead of playing right here, because it's going to take us to the beginning. I don't like that gap, so we're gonna fix that gap too. So we can come up here at the top, very top, and let's see, we're gonna go back to that. So we're gonna put that in. So this is the end of the first part. Come back already. Hey Jack, we might go ahead and throw some samples. I thought I named this track. I don't got nothing right here. I don't know why I skipped the track. Whatever. So it's the hi-hat, snare, pitch. I've got an empty track. So now I'm about to go to my Zone 6 drum kit. So I got four different 808s here. I don't know which one I'm gonna use, but whichever I'm gonna use, I'm gonna hit warp and spread it out on my keys. And just play along with it till we come up with something funky. Yiddy. Which one you think? Pad 1? Pad 5? Pad 9? Pad 13? What y'all think? Y'all probably can't really tell the difference. I'm on the phone. Think about going with that one. I don't want a whole lot going on. Pad 13. All right, we're going to use pad 13. So, remember, to spread it out on the keys, we got to go to warp samples. Go up here to this magic keyboard looking deal. And now here we is. So I'm gonna have to set y'all back down while I experiment for a little bit. Go ahead and save this one more time, just in case. And we're just gonna play and we're just gonna rock with it. Flies tearing my legs up. Y'all gone. I got it now. Let's see if I can get it though. We'll be right back. you have it. We got a kick, a snare, a hi-hat, a sample, and we got 8 bars. One thing, okay, I ain't gonna end it yet. It's an old school track, you know what I'm saying? I'm old school, that young dude, Mo, is the old fool CEO. 2 Square ENT LLC, you know what I'm saying? I like country rap tunes. I'm from the South, man. You know what we gotta throw in here? So I'm gonna name this track 808. We gotta throw us in here. We're gonna go over here. We're gonna switch. We're gonna use not drum pads, not key groups. We're gonna use our plugins. You know what plugins we gonna use though? Take the organs out in the first part, and we're gonna bring it in the second. Or I might use it in the first part too. I gotta set y'all back down. I gotta set y'all back down. Hold on, wait. Alright, let's do it. Let's rock. Let's get it. Almost had it. So I'm gonna go up to my grid mode, and we're gonna listen to it, and we're gonna see where I messed up. We're gonna take that part off, and we just keep rolling. So them last two. Maybe just that last one. Let me see. Oops. Yeah, that's the last two. So thank you. got carried away alone. Almost had it. Almost there. Almost there. So let me see, I'm gonna erase this part too. Let's see, I'm gonna save it real quick. See what we got. We'll see. Almost there. Let me undo that. It didn't erase for whatever reason. Okay. I'm gonna just erase it myself. That's cool. It's flies. Might have to hurry up and get out this car. I'm about to lose my mind. Let me see. Okay. I think I got it now. See? I gotta listen to it real quick. I ain't like that even. Okay, let's just listen the whole thing real fast. And then, this is the last thing I do, probably. What up, kinfolk? So nice of you to join me. You done missed my whole video, though. I'm just about done. But yeah, we're gonna have to get in the lab together, man. I think I got it. Let's see. There we go. Save it.
Saving it.
Okay. So, I told y'all. I like to chop the sample, I may pitch the sample, and I like to add some effects. So one thing I'm going to add to this, I wanted to make it sound bigger. Well, not so much bigger, but louder. Because if I wanted to make it bigger, I'll put reverb on it. So I'm going to use a channel strip and maybe some reverb. So let's listen to the sample now. Well, I'm going to turn it off. And then we listen to it and like halfway through it, and I'm gonna put it sample on. So, I mean effect on. So. Probably can hear it better if I just solo this track. And so, and then like for you to actually really hear it, let me put on the first eight preset. So this is without the effect. Kind of quiet, right? So we got the channel strip effect we're about to put on now. Hear how louder it got? Okay, so now I'm gonna add some reverb, just a little bit. I'm gonna go to my car professional effects. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit, the effect. Cause I just wanted to be louder and bigger sounding. I don't want it to be like sounding crazy or echoey. You probably ain't gonna be able to hear it too much over these phone speakers. But that organ sounds a little on the high side. So what I like about this too, go to my organ, which is on track what, 8. So I'm gonna go to edit my organ and I can pull the drawstrings down. See there? I want to sound darker. Sounds a little too dark though. I'm gonna add some reverb on the organ too. Less is more when you're mixing and stuff. I heard Dr. Dre even say that. So I don't wanna put a whole lot. I just want enough where you can hear the difference. Okay, now I can add keys, bells, I can add a bunch, I can just add forever, but I've already made this video way too long. But one little hack I will show you. So, okay, let me slow down. I'll go to mix, my mixing channel. There's no actual mixing board on here, or the update, they got it. But so I want to go to my main output, what you're hearing, and I'm going to put an effect on here to kind of boost my drums and really give them a nice punchy sound without being too loud. And so one effect on here is you can use this emulator, and it's going to emulate a MPC that you will see on Hustle and Flow. It's the MPC 3000. But I'm going to even use the MPC 60. It's going to emulate that sound. It's going to copy that sound. And one thing about the MPC 3000 and MPC 60 was they were made by Roger Lynn, who made, he really gave the MPCs their sound. And then they ended up having some dispute or whatever, and he left. So after that, the drum machines didn't really have that sound. That's why you see producers still using old gear, because that sound that Roger Lynn made is just, it's phenomenal. So I'm going to select that, and I'm going to let y'all listen to it. You might not hear it on this phone speakers and this car speakers, but I'm going to turn it on and off so you can try to maybe hear it. Save. Try to pay attention to the drums, specifically the kick. Pretty much it, y'all, man. It's old school. That young dude, Mo, was in the old full CL, 2 square ENT, LLC. This has been another beat, man. I hope y'all have a beautiful, blessed day and you're prosperous and prolific in all your ways. Shout out to Rashad. And, man, keep it coming. Keep coming with them ideas, man. This is how it brings out the best of me when I work with other artists and other producers or just people with ideas. It brings out the best of me. So y'all keep tuning in. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Have a beautiful, blessed day and be prosperous and prolific in all your ways. Ye dig. Old school. I'm out. Peace.